this is also compelling, and I know you go back and forth to Washington a lot. Do you have any new insights into why neither political party will say a word about any of this, and they virtually won't even use the word marriage?
So on the left, marriage is seen as kind of a social issue, and they just don't want to touch this issue from what would be seen as a conservative perspective. I think from the right, there is a, particularly among the Republican elites, there is a strong interest and commitment to kind of limited government, obviously, and almost a kind of a libertarian mindset. And they see marriage as a private issue that's not really the purview of government. Not recognizing, of course, that when marriage breaks down, the state steps into the breach, you know. So I think both groups are have their own reasons to avoid this issue. But I think also it's the case that many of the sort of the folks who are sort of driving the discourse and the policy agenda are themselves divorced and don't want to touch the issue for personal reasons too. So I think that's part of the answer to your question.
Sensitive topic, yeah. Thank you, all of you, for being here with us tonight. We hope that you'll take a copy of the report, definitely. We'll be continuing the conversation at familyscholars.org. I hope you'll visit and make comments and let us know what you think. We'll put any further media updates and other discussions that might happen around it on familyscholars.org. Thank you so much for coming tonight. Please stick around, chat with each other, and have a nice time. Thank you.